Okay, we're back, and I brought up quite a few controversial issues there. What I was trying to say was that there's nothing wrong with watching art, and if a movie, which is the art of telling a story really visually, is going to have beautiful meanings in it, is going to show beauty and manifest a human being at their best, really, I'd love to see it. But if every time I'm watching a movie, you're talking to my lower self and trying to provoke me with nude women or, you know, provoke women with nude men or whatever, then I just think that there's a problem with it, and there is a... in a limited zone, a little bit of mutual exclusivity there.
Well, Maz, I think the problem is, though, that a lot of the classic works of literature, classic movies, mm-hmm. a lot of them do have sex, violence, and drugs. And I don't think as Muslims we should necessarily close ourselves from that, because that's part of the real world. Sex, violence, and drugs mm-hmm. are part of our reality on the daily basis.
Well, so is pornography. Would you show it to your child?
No, but I think movies are supposed to reflect the challenges of everyday life. And I think that's...
Well, beautiful. I mean, I'll tell you one thing. I know a director who tries to portray what you know, beautifully pointed out. You want to stay real. That's what you're saying.
Yeah.
And, you know, say he wanted to say that, you know, this character, the protagonist here, is going through a struggle, and, you know, at one point he's going to commit adultery.
Yeah.
Because it's part of life, and the intention is to cure that. Cure this disease of adultery. For example, he can show the guy and the girl walking into the room, the door closing, and a bunch of hey, hi, whatever, ha, 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 and you'll get the point. But to start dwelling onto the actual scene, you know, clothes, all these taken off, all these different things, is to actually want to sell to me by talking to my lower animalistic self, the bestial self in the human being, and you're not taking me anywhere. In fact, you've provoked a desire, and even if you cure the protagonist in the end, psychologists tell you, you're still turned on, and you're still going to look for that type of beautiful girl in life ad infinitum.
Yeah.
You know, but you did bring up a comment, Matt, earlier that I wanted to look at as well.
I think you're referring to, you know...
the anonymity type.
Remaining anonymous in this world so that you can be truly cool in the next
yes, world. I mean, yes. You had a new definition of cool, and I wanted to hear all about it.
Well, from the Islamic understanding, from my understanding of the Islamic understanding...
Of the Islamic understanding.
the idea is that the true izzah, the true honor, mm-hmm. is going to come in the next life, because it's eternal. In this life, you can have name and fame, mm-hmm. but you're going to die.
Okay.
And so no matter what, it's limited in how far it can get
and
you.
And finite.
And it's very finite.
Okay.
And also, is that really the purpose of life, to have name and fame? As many people think and have thought it is,
mm-hmm.
that's a question.
Well, many famous actors and actresses do say that they feel horrible because when they made that their goal and then later on grew older, they felt that it was taken away from them unfairly almost, then they realized they shouldn't have wanted it in the first place. I've heard a lot of them say that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, just with all the desires of the world,
mm-hmm.
whatever they may be, love of money,
right.
love of...
well, lust in general
lust,
is a desire.
And whatever it may be, love of food
compiling,
even,
something
simple like that.
Gold and silver coins.
Whatever it is.
Right.
The idea is that you're going to die, and so you can never truly fulfill these desires. So it can only come in the eternal realm.
So it's very challenging for a religious person, though, or someone who's trying to represent religion to the world, to be able to get this meaning across without sounding condescending, without sounding patronizing, without sounding holier than thou. Because if usually you go up to someone, particularly in the world we live in, where the self is told to completely live itself, discover itself, enjoy itself, you know, own it on DVD. I don't know, all these different ways that provoke the love of owning, the love, and then suddenly someone says, you know what? You're going to die. It's all going to go. It's almost like it's antagonistic, right? So how do you strike that balance?
I think that message is quite negative. And mm-hmm. I think it also portrays religion as somehow otherworldly, that it's not of this world. And I think there's actually some circumstances where passion and desire mm-hmm. for what is in this world actually pushes people to success. And I think you can make an argument that this is part of kind of the individual drive.
Wait, so let's discuss what is success then, because you used
I'm talking
word.
About
Define
whether
success.
It's political success, economic success, achieving what your goals are in this world.
Do you mean having power and money? Is that political and
for example, something like running for Congress or running for Parliament. That is a goal of this world.
You see, but Shed, you have to be careful, because do you want us to desire a worldly goal for worldly sake, or desire a otherworldly goal that necessitates that we have a position in the world? And so that your desire, although outwardly seems to be for that economic right. success, for that political success, inwardly it's actually for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so He gives you that success, because as a khalifa of Allah, and yeah. you know, I want to hear what you want to say about this, but as a khalifa of Allah, as a representative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a trustee, as a successor of God on the planet, we are supposed to have the dunya, but in our hands and not in our hearts. Because it's almost like Allah entrusts us with the world. He gives us the world and He says, because you're going to fear me and love me and everything that you do, you take care of it. Because when you invent a theater, you'll make sure to patent it, like have a patent in a way in which you'll have no nudity shown on it, for example. As opposed to if you don't think about me, let alone maybe even not believe in me, you'll make a theater and you'll be so commerce-driven, so money-driven, money-oriented, that you'll actually put nudity on it because it sells. And again, just as an example, I'm using nudity because we talked about it earlier.
Right, so I think that, say someone is running for parliament, they should have the right intention. Their desire should be a pure one, to help the people around them, to promote justice, democracy.
Can that qualify as a desire for something in the world?
It could. It can be seen, it really depends. I mean,
semantics
in the
here.
End, the intention might be to please God. That might be one intention, which is obviously a positive one.
Mm-hmm. So. But exactly, because I think I agreed in spirit with you in what you said, but I think that it may be misunderstood or misconstrued to mean that sometimes it's positive to want the world for the world's sake, as opposed to want the world for the sake of Allah, to make sure that what the Lord, the creator of the world, wants to see happening in it, happens in it. I mean, do you see the distinction there?
Of course, yeah.
But I think also like promoting justice, democracy, the well-being of the people in your country.
In the world.
Those are things that please God.
Absolutely.
And those are things that are done for God's pleasure as well. So I don't think they're mutually exclusive.
Absolutely. And in that sense, I think I fully agree with you.
Yeah,
وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ. And that Allah commands you that when you judge between humanity, you judge with justice. You do so justly.
Along these lines, Moaz, and tying in with your introduction, which you talked about postmodernism,
right.
There's a question that we could just put out there for discussion. Does God want us to actualize the ideals of Islam, justice, world peace, whatever it may be, in this world, or does He simply want from us the struggle?
Oh.
I mean, is our grand narrative as Muslims the fulfillment of these ideals, or just the path to them?
And then regardless of whether it happens or not, that's up to Him. Very,
exactly.
Very interesting. Well, let's look at this after the break, inshallah. It's a very interesting point. And although you may notice things may have deviated a little bit from the main topic of why is religion a turnoff, not looked at as an in thing nowadays, that still is the great theme of Stairway to Paradise, of these episodes. Because our intention is to look at religion in a way that does actually attract the human soul. Everything beautiful attracts, everything ugly repels you away from it. And so in general, I'm really happy it took us into this tangent, and we'll be back after the break to look at it, inshallah.